Okay, so Kal Kalosh, we're starting. We are in the Seif over here in the Yalkut Yosef, which speaks about, is a Mohel allowed to leave his house even though he's going to be leaving his wife and children? So he's annulling from Oneg Shabbat. And now we're going to speak about another very interesting halacha. Is the husband allowed to leave his house during the Hagim? Okay? So let's see what it says over here. It's right over here. So it says over here like this. יש שכתבו לחלק בזה בין שמחת יום טוב שהוא מן התורה, וקיים לנישה בעלה משמחה. So some people come and they say they want to be מחלק between שמחת יום טוב, which is from the Torah, and we know that the husband is going to make his wife happy, and between Oneg Shabbat, that it's only going to be מדרבנן. וכן גדה בשוט אבני נזר. So it's brought down in אבני נזר. Which means that maybe by the Doraita, which is Yom Tov, is a problem, but the Drabanan of Oneg Shabbat, there's no problem. So even though the Mohel is going to leave his city, and he's going to have to leave his family, and he's going to go to some village in order to do the Brimila, he should be obligated to do so. However, though, ach, yesh litchot, maybe we could push
it. Wait, 1 second, Rabbi, 1 second. We just spent the last 3 nights stating that Oneg Shabbat is machloket if it's midrabanan or midoraita, and is the comparison now between Yom Tov calling it minatorah. I don't know. We haven't seen that yet, where that's written. But it's to simply assume now the benonek Shabbat shenora midrabanan. So that's it. That's the derech he chose.
No.
That's a mitzvah deoraita.
That's by Yom Tov.
Exactly.
He's asking on the. Ronnie,
no, I get it. But now that what he's talking about here is about a mitzvah of lesameach, et aisha, and this, if that's considered onik, so fine. If you want to say that's onik. But then again, at the end, I think that Rabbi Tzak Yosef came out that truthfully, the onik Shabbat could be from the Torah. There is some opinions that say the Rabbanan, but we're going to hold that it's in the Torah. And now he's saying an aside. He's bringing a side now that wants to say that maybe you can make a difference that it's not written mefurash anywhere that it's from the Torah. There are those who say that the mitzvah of the Hagim that is mamash mefurash written is different. I know, no Rabbi, that's what he's trying to say basically.
Yeah, he's basically saying that some people wanted to make a differentiation between Yom Tov and Shabbat because Yom Tov is Doraita and that's everybody, right? And that's what he said. It's right. Right, and that's an entire concept of Simcha on Yom Tov, and then you have the Oneg Shabbat that it's only the Rabbanan, and that's what's
also. Also, can't you say that there's a difference between the mitzvah of Simcha and the mitzvah of Oneg?
That we learned yesterday. Yes,
exactly.
We learned that yesterday.
So here we're talking about Simcha.
Yeah, that's what we learned here above. Yesterday, I don't remember if it was.
So then, that would be comparing apples and oranges. Then the whole question falls apart.
You're right.
I don't think we should make the distinction yet between Simcha and Oneg. I think for the matter of the three lines that we just read, we'll just call it Oneg.
So no,
there's
why?
No question.
No,
you're
why?
Saying,
why?
I don't think you understood my question. My question is, the last 3 nights, we made a chiluk that there's many opinions that say Oneg Shabbat is minatorah. And there are some also that say it's midrabanan. Fine. And now, as it relates to Simcha Yom Tov, which clearly everybody agrees is minatorah, he says, okay, but what about if you're going to compare it to Shabbat, she'enola midrabanan? That's not what we concluded. Oneg Shabbat is machloket. Unless tonight we're going to say that that's the side that Yalkut Yosef takes. That Oneg Shabbat is midrabanan. That's my question.
He wasn't paskening like that. He's bringing some people that are mechalek. He himself does not.
Okay,
say
so
he himself holds it's doraita, right? Or the majority, or that, you know, he doesn't want to get into machlokot. So that's why we learned yesterday in the Leshem Yichud, don't say mefurash. Get yourself out of machlokot. But for himself, it is probably much more doraita than drabanan. And that was the tendency of what he's going. But here, though. We learned this also here. Look what I put on the note. Ela de la sovrim de v'shabbat lekachiyu simcha elachiyu oneg mashiach lesameach et ishto b'shabbat uvifrat simchat ishto me'erev shabbat b'vgadim v'akati ishto man v'azot v'yesho tzar. You remember, this is where he's making differentiation between oneg and simcha. Okay, so he already did it over here. But now we're going to see also. But hold on 1 second, right? So one more time.
Yeah,
What?
Right, but I'm saying, but that is a mitzvah that he had of lesameach et ishto. So he said, that, when does it fall? Before Shabbat. On Shabbat itself, that's it. You already got her the gifts and the this and that. So that's what that was, the chiluk that he wanted to say there. But again, that's again the whole thing on a mitzvah of simcha, and that's why he wanted to say that maybe once I did it, I'm done already.
He said that on Shabbat, there's no chiyuv of simcha. There's only a...
Right, it's erev simcha. Erev, well, it's not that it's not. It's just that it would fall from before, because you're mekayem et dam mitzvah from before by buying her the clothing,
Meaning, even if it would apply simcha, it would apply from before. However, right. Though, what he's trying to say though is that there's no simcha on Shabbat. Meaning the simcha is not on Shabbat. The simcha is on Yom Tov. Shabbat is Oneg. It's a different din. It's two different dinim. Even though, but let's see. Let's just see. Let's see what he says here. Look, one more time. Right? He's saying like this. Some people wrote down to make a differentiation between Simchat Yom Tov, which is the Raita, and we paskin Isha Balam Esamcha, and Oneg Shabbat, which is the Rabbanan. And that's what's wrote down in Avnei Nezer. Ach yesh idchot. The exact same thing what he just wrote down on the top of the page. That which we said that the simcha is that he's buying or clothing for the chag. But it doesn't mean that, meaning the mitzvah of simcha is not that he has to be physically with her on the chag. It just means before chag, you took care of her necessities. So you made sure that you bought her clothing, you bought her whatever she needed, and now, right? A los suegros. Yeah. Now take her, send her away. Yeah? So he says, אבל אינו מחויב להיות אימא בחג. ומה שכתב הרמב״ם וחייב אדם להיות בהן שמח וטוב לב, הוא ואשתו ובניו, לאו דווקא שיהיו ביחד, it doesn't mean that to be ממש together, אלא לדאוג להם שיהיו צריכים, he just has to make sure that they have to be happy, they have to be jolly. Yeah? That's the best shalom bayit, no? So he says, "Ure b'shut ichavedat." Look at b'shut ichavedat. However, though, the Chazon Ovadia lichot Yom Tov katav she'en la'bala niachdishov linsol le'rabo. So not only just to go to Uman, even to your own rabbi, you're not allowed to go to visit him. He says, "Why?" Sharem mitzvah min haTorah lismoach b'Yom Tov yachad nishtov benav. But there's a mitzvah from the Torah to be sameach with your wife and children yachad together. He says, "Uchmo shenemar v'samachta ata uvetecha." It's you and your house. So he says, "Umvoar desfilalei shemichuyav liot ima b'chag." So it comes out that according to the Chazon Ovadia, you are obligated to be with your wife and children for the chag. Kanireh shavin the biur b'ma shamru ba'alas v'samcha haynu yichtav. So obviously, Rav Ovadia learned that when it says that the husband is going to make her rejoice, it means mamash together. Uvifrat kasher nosim kam yamin lifnei chag. And especially if you're going to travel a few days beforehand, and you're going to come back a few days afterhand, and then the woman is staying by herself. Right? Or does he have to go more than 10 mil in his city? Limkom. Right? It says over here. Here we're talking about the Beta Cholim, Mashasham Yoledet, Varach Nimol. I don't know why are they doing it in the Beta Cholim. Okay, I don't know. They're doing it in the hospital. Right, where the woman is in the Rach Nimol, Mishul Mila Bizmana. Yeah? Ve'on Nishal Sham, Hecha Shema Mechalim, right? If you're going to be your Mechalel Shabbat Yom Tov, Ubaim Lasham Mea Mishpach Mochrit. Or what happens when you have, sometimes this is a very famous question, right? You're going to have a Brit Milah on Shabbat, and you know that half the family are going to come, they're all Mechalel Shabbat and Yom Tov. So what do you do? Right? So it says, V'gam me'ashnim, they smoke, im nidche ha'milah liyom me'alef. Should you push it off to Sunday? Right? V'yashiv, and he answered, Damuel tzarich litzoh al l'sham erev Shabbat Yom Tov, im yevshal lech l'sham Shabbat Yom Tov atzmam, shalekam apos mitzvat onek Shabbat v'rak midibre Kabbalah. He says, no. Since according to some poskim, it's only the Rabbanan, sa, yeah, travel, go. Vayim etshuvat tashbetz. So he says, look in the tashbetz. Betoch divrei tochacha leoto shedacha mila bizmana, to the person that he pushed off the mila in the proper time. Yom tisha be'av, mishum suda mila. So he was on tisha be'av, but he pushed it off to the next day because he wanted to make a big suda. So what happened? So he says, al ze katav diyoter karov haya lasot suda be'oto yom, לעבור על הסה של דברי קבלה, ולא לעבור... שאיסור האכילה בתשעה באב על הסה של דברי קבלה, המילה בזמנה היא הסה של דברי תורה אין שם. You understand what he just said? He says, it would have been better for you to do the seudav brit milah on tisha be'av and eat it on tisha be'av than to you, for you to push off the brit milah to the next day. He says, why? Eating on tisha be'av is a mitzvah to say of divrei kabbalah, of the rabbis. He says, brit milah bizmanah is doraita. So what are you doing? That goes against all norms. Obviously, you're not allowed to go against him. You should have to have seudah של מצווה, but you could do it the next day. אבל הכי, מי אפשר רק על ידי ביטול עונג שבת, מילה בזמנה עדיף, איתם הנזכר, but it's better because of the reason we mentioned before, right, that it's only going to become of the רבנן. ואין שם את השבת שכתב עוד אף עם האב כאן, even if the father is here, אין מצווה זו מנתלת על בית דין, אלא אם כן עבר ונמנע. It's not going to be on the בית דין, unless he doesn't want to do the ברי מילה. זה איתם ברמב"ם, אבל לא כשהוא מתעצל בה, not just סתם he's being מתעצל, מכל מקום חייבים לקופו אפילו לידי הקאות, לעשות בזה, but we could even hit him, we'll give him beatings to make sure that he's going to do the mitzvah, okay? הוא מבואר בדרך ביקודך עד אליו דווקא בדין, but every single Jew is called a בדין to do this. So everyone could just come and start giving him palos, boom, 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 you just give it to them, yeah? So he says, הוא כבר קדמו הרמם בלילו של משניות, הנה אף דה ונוגע לעניין כפייה, now even though to do with beating him up, for sure you need a בדין דווקא, אז ברות אנו חתם סופן, אבל אם יש בידו למחוק, הוא יישא בכלל זה, you should actually be מוחה. You should rebuke him. ראינו בתשובה חתם סופן, בתשובת זקן אהרון, וכנראה שזה טעם הרשב"א, that's the reasoning of the רשב"א, that he brought down the פסק הלכה in the רמה, that the betin are the ones that are כופין את המוהל. למול בחינם, to do it for free. If there's no other person to do the מילה, ואין יד האיש מסק, that means what happens? You have a case. Yeah, the guy can't pay the מוהל. Yeah, you have a case. Guy can't pay the mohel. Betin will come and force the mohel to do it for free if there's no other mohel. It says, why? Because at the end of the day, that's what it's saying over here, the betin are the ones that are going to force him. Ki ha-mitzvah mutelet al mohel kemo la betin. Because the mitzvah is on both of them, on the mohel and the betin. Because since the father wants to do the brit milah, and he gave it to the mohel, and there's no other mohel, so the mohel is instead of the father. So we force him to do it because the mitzvah is on him. And if so, Kevin Shehu Ahmed bin Kumar, since he's instead of the father, Hech Ye Hava Mina, what's the Hava Mina that you're going to push off the mitzvah because of Oneg Shabbat? Or even because of mitzvah Simchat Yom Tov? Just like it doesn't help, right? Kol Zeh Be'av Gufe by the father himself. Shere'av Toche Shabbat B'Melacha Gmura, it's going to push off even the Duraita. Ichtivu Yom HaShegnim, Yom HaBratzato, Afilu B'Shabbat. Ve'gam Acherim Zulat, even the other people could do it. Are there a lot of people Chalel Shabbat? Ve'koshken Shemvatlim Oneg Shabbat, Simchat Yom Tov Yishum Mitzvah Milah, ואין בתשובת הרשב"א על עניין מוהל שמבקש תשלומים בעד המילה, שהביא ממנהג הגלילות, ומוהל אני מחזר אחר, אבי הבן, ראי להתחסד עמו שייתן לו בנו למולו בחינם, ומרבה עליו רעים כדי להסתכל במצווה. אם כן מדינות נדענה ממצינו שהמוהלים קיצרו רגליהם מבית המשפחה מחתם למילה, ראי שחל בשבב יום טוב כדי לזכו במצווה. So it comes out that he said that many times they were מוהלים עניים, that they used to go around. By looking for an Aviya Ben to do chesed with them in order to do it for free. Right? So he comes and he says, Umarbe alav reim kedei lisakel b'mitzvah. So he has a lot of friends in order that they should have a, do the mitzvah. So in our case as well, you see the Moalim used to go far, right, and wide and all over the place just to do the mitzvah, the brit milah, in order to do the mitzvah. Okay?
So he's not friendly to a woman.
Rav Ovadia was never friendly to a woman. He was very against it. Every year he used to speak against it. All the time. Yeah, and by the way, you should know where you could see it is from this Chazon Ovadia on Hilchot Yom Tov. Because you're obligated to be Mesameach et Ishtecha ve'abanim shelcha v'yom tov itself. Somebody once told me also, it's terrible for chinuch. Just think about it. Let's say people have boys. You understand? Well, you're going to take your boy as well. Saying not everyone takes their boys. You understand? But what? You're going to take your boy. You're going to go by yourself. Leave the boy there. He's with the mother. When is she going to come to the tefillah? When is it? It's a mess. You understand? It's not... I know people that they've done it. And they always went by themselves for years and years. Then afterwards you think to yourself, what about the chinuch of the children? Fine. Next. Im mutar latzet chutz latchum lamul letakatan. No, I apologize. I was just going back up here to see how he just answered this. Right? This, the only way that he answered this was basically just saying that there is a mitzvah to do it together. And not like this person wanted to say that it's separate. You understand? Even though he didn't actually, you know, here go into the fact of the, of, you know, disproving this concept of shiyesh katvu lechalek between Simchat Yom Tov and Oneg Shabbat, you know, about the Doraita the Rabbanan, he didn't really... Okay, fine. Okay. Im mutar latzet chutz l'tchum. Are you allowed to go outside of the tchum in order to do bri milah for a katan? Umila shechala b'shabbat. Ve'en shamuel el ami shenimtza b'ir ha'smucha. So imagine there's a milah on Shabbat, there's no muhel, only the guy that's in the next city. Im mutar l'muhel l'chatzel l'chutz l'tchum. Can he go out of the tchum? The 2,000 amot. Letzorach ha'milah for the milah. V'kaimelan k'chachamim yisum paskalim v'chachamim pirkat d'ar-li'ezer milah. The only milah itself pushes off the Shabbat. But machshireh milah, which is anything which is a preparation for the milah, is not going to be doche the Shabbat. Okay? V'hachachash machshireh milah. So this is also the preparation of the milah. Because you have to travel there to get there. It's preparation. V'zeh lashon Rambam, osim kol tzorchei milah b'Shabbat, malim, orin, you do the milah, you do the priya, you do the metzitza. Milah is the cutting. Priya is the splitting of the two parts, right? Of the inner skin. Okay, and then you have the motzin, the metzitza, the chozer tzir makmin, and you're even allowed to go back and cut any types which are, any pieces which are still akev, av bishapidesh, that tzin shen makmin, kozman shlo pidesh, venoten alea isplanit, aval machshire mila, va machshire mila, enan dochin et ha-shabbat, do not push off Shabbat, keitzar, what's the case? Hane shlo matzul sakin, why don't they can't find a knife? So enosin sakin, you can't make a knife on Shabbat, and they're not going to bring it from somewhere else. Which is not meurav, and mevino to mechatzel lechatzel. You cannot bring him from one chatzel to another chatzel. Ben iruv midivrehem nidche b'vnei abat sakin. So even the isur de rabbanan of an eruv, right, is not going to come and push off from right. This we say he's not going to push off the salacha as well, okay, because of bringing the knife. Because you could have brought him erev Shabbat. Because the nidesh shel amoel latzel chutzchum. So from here he comes out. You don't have to go outside of the tchum. Right, and to be over on the Isur in order to do the Brit Milah. Chayetzev zedanu acharim yutal avol lisot tchumin letzor tfilah betzibur. It's another interesting question. Can I be over on tfilah, on tchumin to do tfilah betzibur? Okay, so it says, Yichashiv kemitzah mutal al gavra shemutal bavura lasot tidu betchumin, or lo? Am I going to consider it like a mitzvah which is on the human being, on the person, which you're allowed to do so? And you're allowed to do it with tchumin or not? So we'll look in the shoot maril shekdav shem marisega l'shulam l'shum bosek shemutal l'aret tchumin l'lecha betekneset k'dei l'itpalel basara. Which means you're not allowed to come and make a new tchum in order to go to the betekneset to pray with 10 people. They lo ashkechan sheitzichu chumin l'palel basara. They didn't obligate you in such a case. Ayinu shelo itiru l'asot eruv tchumin l'tzor tfilah betzibur. V'in idashim b'tochum yisrael ha-mitzvah kol kach, it's not such a mitzvah. Ezu ma'ala gdola v'chovat ishtalu v'kabalat ha-tfilah. Aval eno mitzvah kol kach, means even though it's a ma'ala gdola and it's something in order to receive our tefillot, but it's not a mitzvah kol kach that shiatiru avura la'asot eruvei tchumim. But not just stam that you're going to start doing eruvei tchumim. Achasama katav garsin imperek bekol me'arevin. Em me'arevin eruvei tchumim l'levar mitzvah. For example, go to the brit milah or the tefillah. So here he's telling you mefurash that you could do eruvei tchumim for tefillah. Kem delen shem mitzvah iniach eruv. Mutal alechet kol hayom kulo, afilu dvar reshut. So then you could go for any other reason as well. So he comes out from the samak, for the tefillah, you are allowed to do it with tchumim, because it's a dvar mitzah. By Mali Rabba, that he brings down the samak. Chenu besefer aniyar, shekdav em arvin l'mitzah, gon l'tefillah v'l'drasha, ul'beta avel l'bet mishtah shedda mitzvah v'chay yotzem zeh. Chen zav ha-magen Avraham, elfi ma shekdav no mesiman tzadik tziva v'adai share, chen ma shman ma shekdav mesiman shinyudah v'sif alef, sif bet, if you're obligated to travel 72 minutes in order to get a minyan, you understand? This, by the way, you should know is the biggest musar that we give to people. That if you have to travel 72 minutes in order to go to a minyan, right? Imagine what it is in such a case where you have a minyan 5 minutes away and you don't go. You understand? So it's a very, very big, and it's Shulchan Aruch Mefurash. It's not like anybody argues. Okay? So in Ken, if so, we see that it's a mitzvah rabbah. Zem mikre, and this is going to be called Me'arvin Ledvar Mitzvah. We're going to do an Aruf for a Dvar Mitzvah. The Omnam, however, though, Av Shem Magen Avraham Yechriya Shem Latin, even though the Magen Avraham was Machriya to be Matin, Shomar Dezeu Rak the Mikre Me'arvin Ledvar Mitzvah. Maybe this is only considered that you're doing an Aruf for a Dvar Mitzvah. But to push off an Isur Drabbanan, maybe not. Meaning, maybe you could only do a positive. So I'm going to give you a heter to do a Revet Chumin for a Dvar Mitzvah. But to come and to push off an Isur Drabbanan, I wouldn't say that. Mash Vatsir Begitin, Rabbi Eliezer Shechrer Avdo, Rabbi Eliezer freed his slave, right? And there, when he freed his slave, it's even it's a positive commandment of Le'olam Ba'em Ta'avod. Lichol HaChazin Dafilu Doraita Dachina. Kol Shekin Shvud Drabbanan. If you can push off Doraita, Kol Shekin Shvud Drabbanan, Kumakom Shehane Zakiyo Rabin Da'adif. There at Zikui Rabin was there, we had 9 people. We needed a 10th. So he freed his Eved Kena'ani. So even though there's a Averah to do so, because it says, Le'olam Ba'em Tavodu, you always have to make sure that they're working for you. But here we're going to permit it because of Zikui Rabin. But for you itself, there's no Zikui Rabin. If he's a Danuch and Mutala shoot, Befaren Betoch HaTchum Shabbat, are you allowed to start swimming with a, I don't know what this is, this Faren? Inside of the Tchum on Shabbat for Tfilah B'Simur. For example, that they're sitting in a Kfar Samukhayim, and there's a river, and they want to pass it. Right, with La'avor Ma'avor B'Shabbat L'Yipalel Basara, they want to pass it with a boat. So look at the Yalkut Yosef, or with a raft. Right? So look at the Yalkut Yosef Shabbat Krachei. Okay? Until here we're clear?
Yeah. Just interesting where he says that there is no mitzvah. Like he says, there's no mitzvah really on praying with a minyan. It's not written anywhere. But then he brings the others, but it doesn't say where they learned that it's a mitzvah. No?
You're talking about the samak.
Yeah, the samak, for example, says, yeah, it's a big mitzvah. It's a big mitzvah because look what they make you do to go back. That could just mean that it's a good thing. It doesn't mean that it's a mitzvah.
No, that was going back was the Magen Avraham. That's over here.
Right. I get it. But even the Samak.
You have other people which are Rishonim already. The Samak is a Rishon. He doesn't need a...
Yeah. But he shouldn't say that from where is a mitzvah. Bring me a proof where it's a mitzvah. Because the Rishon, he's saying it's a mitzvah. But from where do we learn that it's a mitzvah? Is it Takanat Chachamim? It was written somewhere. Because that's what looked like to be at the beginning when he starts. And he says, "Ainu shelo yitiru lasot." He says that Palel Basara ina kol kach mitzvah sheachol lekaven et tefilato bebeito.
Because at the end of the day,
that's why.
100%.
And he says,
"So you get finish."
No. I'm saying that he says, "De lo ashkachan." Right? He says, "De lo ashkachan sheitzriku chamim leitzvah Basara." He says, "Because I don't find anywhere where it says that you have to."
No, but then he explains those words. V'hainu, that means to say, shelo itiru la'asot eruv tchumin letzor tefilah b'tzibur. That's explanation. Meaning on that last line that he says, telo ashkachan shetzichu chamim yipalel basara, is not true. Look in Maran, Shulchan Aruch, Siman Tzadi. Mefurash, he says. And it's not only Maran, it's everybody. Everyone says that you should pray tefilah b'tzibur.
Right. You should, but it's not like a mitzvah, no?
No. So that's what he's saying. He's saying that these words, when the Maharil, this is the Maharil Segal, when the Maharil Segal came and they said, I lost the word.
Right there.
Yeah, he says, V'hainu adkan, that's adkan l'shonam. However, that's a pshat. Meaning to permit you to do eruvet chumin for tefillah b'tzibur, we didn't find. But to go to tefillah b'tzibur, everybody told you to go to tefillah.
But are you sure, Rabbi? Because if you keep reading, he says, "V'nikdashti beruch ben Israel, ena mitzvah kol kach, bezuma ala gedola v'chova v'shtadlu de kabbalat tefillah, avala ena mitzvah kol kach sheitiru, sheitiru mitzvah kol kach."
No. Aval ena mitzvah kol kach sheitiru avura la'asot erubet chumin. You understand? He's explaining the logic behind it, which means that the Maharil Segal and the Maharil, what they're coming and telling you is that, listen, nobody's going to tell you Chas v'Shalom, Tefillah b'Tzibur is not important. You understand? Right? 100%. Right? But ad kedei kach to permit you to do eruvei tchumim for no other reason, meaning there's no other reason. I don't need to do the eruvei tchumim. There's only one reason, to go to tefillah. So he says, that I don't know. That I don't need to. Now remember, they are rishonim, right? And now, sorry, some of them are not even rishonim. No, the Maharil was a rish. The Maharil was a rishon. The Maharil was a rishon. Okay, in the name of Maharil Saga. So they were rishonim, and the Samak is a rishon. So you just have a machloket rishonim, right? So there's no, it's not like I need to bring a proof or you need to bring a proof. I said that you don't need to, you're not allowed to do eruvei tchumim to do tefillah b'tzibur, right? And you're that also a rishon, the same contemporary, you're going to say you do need, you're allowed to. It's not like I need a proof, you understand? The nigdashti is already brought down. And from that pasuk of the nigdashti, we do learn the obligation of tefillah b'tzibur. According to the Zohar HaKadosh, it's a doraita because of kiddusha, right? According to the Zohar, according to the to Maran, it's not, right? But for sure, you do have it over there. But what he's just trying to bring out is that it's not enough to do a eruv tchumim. That's the explanation, okay? And however, though, then when he continued, it said that the Samach said mefurash that it's not true because he said dvar mitzvah and he brought down tefillah, okay? And then he said the Liyaraba Paskin like the Samak as well. Then he brought down the Niyar also, the brought down also, right? Tfilah and Rasha and Betavel Betumishte. Then he brings down the Magin Avraham, right? And then he brings down the proof from Maran about going for meal. Okay, but then here he wants to push it off. Because here he wants to say that even though the Magin Avraham was Machriya to be Matir, maybe it's only Matir to do an Eruv for a dvar mitzvah. Because again, okay, I'm permitting you to do something positive, but to permit you to do a derabbanan, to go out of the tchum, maybe it's not going to push it off. Ah, we find by Rabbi Eliezer that he did do that. He did push it off because he pushed off a mitzvah because he went and he freed his slave. He says, no, there was Zikui Rabim. Zikui Rabim was completely different. Here it's not Zikui Rabim. They have a minyan without me. I just want to pray with tefillah b'tzibur. So therefore, there's no Zikui Rabim. Okay, and then he says, so then the same halacha would apply about going on a boat or raft, whatever it is. I think this is a raft, but I'm not really sure. I can't say 100%. Okay. Next. En mevarechim al mitzvat oneg shabbat. You do not make a beracha on oneg shabbat. Achar she'en bazeh davar mugdal lekiyum ha-mitzvah. Because there's nothing which is very precise to tell us what is the mitzvah. Okay, and then it says, "V'gam niftarim bebikat hakiddush, or bebikat hadlaka, ve'otamim." You're also going to become patur with the beracha of the kiddush. Okay, let's see the footnote because what does that mean, right? And the beracha and the hadlaka and other reasons as well. Okay, so let's see what it means here. Okay, hine. Yeah, the reasoning why you don't make a bracha on Oneg Shabbat, Hagam Shezu Mitzvah Mdivre Kabbalah, it's a Mitzvah Mdivre Kabbalah. Neymar Bazeh Hei Tamim, there are five reasons brought down. Right, without actually looking, let me go back up. Right, what reasons would you guys tell me?
Well, just by looking at it, you could say it's like the mitzvah of tzedakah that you don't say before, because again, you can do it. There's no, like, what's what he said? There's no mugdar. It doesn't have a set of how like much.
The last one is anything anything which does not have a dvar kitzbah, like kibud avayim or tzedakah or other things. Even though tzedakah also has other reasons, because it's talui b'dat acherim. But that you can't say by here. Also. But to do with the concept of anything which is not, meaning there's no gvul. You could do Oneg Shabbat, the entire Shabbat, but every single 2 minutes, I'm going to take a chocolate bar, right? Shakol Yavivaro and Al Oneg Shabbat, right? I'm going to take what's it called? Sushi. Yeah, I'm going to take have a nice cup of Coke. You understand all these things? But you're going to tell me every single 2 seconds.
I guess that's why it says you're Niftar Bavirkat HaKiddush, just like in the Torah. When you're going to study Torah, in the morning you say Birkat HaTorah. And that is good for the whole day. So I guess here too, once you said the Birkat of Kiddush, that's it. The whole thing that you do, it's lechnechvot Oneg Shabbat.
Right, but no, but it's true, but it's very interesting because that means that the Kiddush in itself, you have to have that in mind, or in the Laka, which Halaka is Halaka Nerot. So I guess the fact that she's lighting candles, you are benefiting from it, and that's why you're doing it. I don't know. You know, it's very, very interesting. There's another probably few reasons that you could probably think about. And why wouldn't you make a Beracha on Oneg Shabbat?
I just have an issue again with the way he starts the Perush down there. Hagam shezu mitzvah midivrei kabbalah aweh. The assertion that Oneg Shabbat is midivrei rabbanan. I still don't understand what is the position.
No, remember midivrei kabbalah is in general. Does midivrei kabbalah could mean doraita as well?
And that is just borrowing the lashon of the Rambam.
Yeah. Okay.
The Rambam is the one who zoches that is the rabbanan.
Machloket.
Machloket and how to understand the Rambam. Remember.
Understand the Rambam. Yeah.
Okay.
Fine. But he's just borrowing the words of the Rambam. Depends on.
Yeah. Everyone, many times they're going to bring down Divrei Kabbalah because it's mefurash for Divrei Kabbalah. You understand? But is doraita or not? Well, again, you know, he already spoke about that. You know, he left it away. He left. You know, you put it away basically. So number one, Torah Shabbat. Katav the kemen shel davar mugdar b'mam mekayim mitzvot Oneg Shabbat uvamai tanag achal nevarech. There is no precise gedder what it is. So v'chaytzev zekadav Rashba shekol mitzvah shel akitzba. שביד אדם למאי בה או להרבו בה, הם מברכים עליה, על פי זה כתב בהגדת מעשה ניסים, yeah? להגאון החוות דעת, בשם עריף, המעריף, שהם מברכים על סיפור יציאה מצרים, אם יש לזה שיעור. The same reason why, on Friday night, on Pesach night, we didn't make a ברכה on סיפור יציאה מצרים. Why not? There's no שיעור. You should be up all night saying סיפור יציאה מצרים. So since there's no שיעור, right, you don't make a bracha on it. Okay? Urel ma'aram shik, she'ira ze mikol divra rambam zal, in sham ya'inu b'mi'ini. Number two, ve'ol katav sham, another reason. Shemvarchim ala lakat ner, shimushum shalom beto. Why do you do ala lakat ner Shabbat? Because of shalom bayit. U'potrim bazeh gam mitzat Oneg Shabbat. So you do also Oneg Shabbat, it's part of the halakat nerot. She'kol tanuge Shabbat, mitzvah achatem. Because the fact that it's, well, obviously, I guess it's the oneg when you have shalom bayit, which means that the fact that right now you are going to make a bracha on halakha nerot, that in itself is already a one bracha for all the things of Oneg Shabbat. Okay? Number three, v'shut keren David tiretz, shenichlal b'chlal b'rikat ha-kiddush, she'omer mekadesh ha-shabbat. When you say to sanctify the Shabbat, it already includes that. Yesh ha'yu no'agim lechavem b'zemer, by kol mekadesh. ופסיקה ברוך השם אשר נתן מנוחה למוישראל, לעשה בזה כברכה על מצווה של עונג מנוחה בשבת, נוקד בפסקי תשובות. So he says it was a special song of Kol Mekadesh, right, that they used to sing, but that was purposely there, right, in order to come and in order to do it over there. Okay? Next, ועוד אפשר ליישב, דאם מברכים אלא על מצווה נעשית מיד בבת אחת. You only make a bracha, this is an interesting one. You only make a bracha on something that you do it all at once, right? Aval mitzvat Oneg Shabbat nimshechet lechol hayom. Interesting. Which means Oneg Shabbat is not now, it's entire Shabbat. So since it's entire Shabbat, how are you going to make a bracha on it? Make a bracha now and then it's for the entire day. You understand? So therefore, since it's continuing, right, the entire day, therefore, and you don't do a miyad, so therefore, you don't make a bracha on it. Right? V'chayotzev zeh ketav betach vid, v'ma shem v'arachim agim nesulot Shabbat, shem v'arachim al mitzvah nasik v'atachav lo efsek. Also the same reason why we don't make a bracha on it, shalosh sudot. Why not? He says, because at the end of the day, it has to be done in one time without efsek in between. But given sudot, if you would have done them in one shot, you're not going to mitzvah chuvah. So therefore, you're not going to make a bracha. Just like we remember the example also by the Dalek, also by the Pesach. Same thing. If you all drank all four cups in one shot, you're not going to be tzedek chuvah. Hey. Another answer. And by the way, you should know, I was thinking of the question that over here, I think there's a difference also between the action and between the mitzvah the entire day. Because for example, shechita, you make one beracha, and that beracha will be the entire day, right? The only thing is, it's not on the day. It's on this, on what you're doing, and as long as you don't have hesech hadat, you could continue doing it. Or putting up mezuzot, right? It could take you a few hours to put up mezuzot, right? But as you make one beracha, it's on everything. Understand? But again, I think it's on, there's a difference between the two.
No, I thought of that. I thought of not those. I actually was thinking of like the mitzvah of checking for chametz. But the problem why I think it doesn't fit is because the mitzvah, truthfully, even the examples that the Rav brought, even those examples, there's no shiur in that. If I just did one shaita and I stopped, I left, I was mekayem the mitzvah. Oneg Shabbat, it goes the whole Shabbat. If I do a little bit of Oneg Shabbat now, and then the rest of the time I'm not doing Oneg Shabbat, did I be mekayem? I don't know if you're mekayem, because it's a mitzvah that is constant. The whole Shabbat you have to do.
No, even though I agree with you, it's constant, but it's very difficult to tell me you're not mekayem. Let's say, for example, I'm going to come and on Friday night I have a lavish meal. And then on Shabbat morning, we were invited to a bar mitzvah. Ilo alenu bar minan. They served us the gefilte fish with the I don't know what there. And you starved. So now what? You didn't do one on Shabbat?
No. That's not what I meant. I mean, maybe I said that. That's not what I meant. What I meant is that it's not a mitzvah that stops. In other words, if I have Sahdat and I leave and I go, well, now it's Sunday. You know, and then I come back 20 minutes later. And I go, no, it's Shabbat. It's still the same mitzvah of Oneg Shabbat that I did on the Kiddush at the beginning. In other words, the mitzvah continues. Whereas all the other ones, if I stop, the mitzvah stops and I got to restart again. Shehita. I did a shehita and then I said, I'm going to the beach. And then I come back. You know what? Chaval, I should do another one. I'm coming back. I'm going to do the mitzvah again. I got to do the blessing again. The searching of the Hamid. I did 2 minutes. Right. Exactly. And okay. That's why you don't continue. And that's what I was thinking. I was trying to think of a mitzvah that is different, but I can't think of one.
No, it's true, because again, the one of the shechita I just thought it was because at the end of the day, it's on the action, on this action. So as long as I never meet Ivsek, I just continue going. I could do another 500 shechitot. It's Erev Kippur, and I'm doing kaparot and kapara for one, kapara for the other, kapara for everybody, and I just continue going. Yeah? Fine.
Why can't we say Mekadesh, the Merecha Mekadesh Shabbat also includes Oneg Shabbat as well? Because when you Mekadesh something, you're putting it at a different position where from the weekday, no? So it could include the Oneg.
That was Gimel, no?
That's what he said, I think.
Oh, I missed that then.
Okay. Yeah, that was Gimel. Gimel, that was this one.
You were stuffing your face then at that moment.
I was. It's true. I just finished dinner.
No perdonas uno,
sleep with one eye open tonight, baby.
Fine. So then it says like this. Veodie Somar, this is hey. Yeah? Alfima Shakdavashut Keren David Anal. According to what we just wrote down because of the Mekadesh Shabbat, Ushut Arugata Bosem and Arugata Bosem. Right? That the reason why, why don't you also make a beracha on Erev Kippur? It's a mitzvah to eat the entire day of Erev Kippur. I remember Rabbi Fiveshevitz, that was the only day in the year they used to be able to come into class with food. So he used to come in with food, with candies, everything. Erev Kippur was a seudah. All the whole day, just eat. Right, just eat. Mitzvah, just eat. And you know what? Interestingly enough, what happens Erev Kippur? Nobody's hungry. Yeah? Always. Fine. So he says over here, so what happens? He says, so why don't we make a beracha b'emet on achilah of Yom Kippur? If it's not nikar that you're doing it for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so you're not going to make a beracha on it. So according to this, you don't make any beracha on a mitzvah sikhlit. For example, getting up for a Tamil Chacham or for an elder, Gemilut Chassadim, Kibud Avayim. So there's another reason, right? Not only because of the Shiur, it's just because you don't know that you're doing it for a Kadosh Baruch Hu. I'm going to do Kibud Avayim because it's normal. It's something logical, but not because it's Be'emet the mitzvah from the Torah or the HaKadosh Baruch Hu is telling me to do it. So according to this, Wadin Seudat Shabbat. Who knows that you're eating for Shabbat? I'm eating because I'm hungry. I want to have my lunch and I want to have my dinner and I want to have my everything else. You could tell the mitzvah. So since he's telling us to do this mitzvah, yeah, so he says, Kigon, for example, yeah, he told us that we have to eat matzah. Matzah is something different. Maror. Nobody's going to eat maror for no reason. Understand? Who and he himself, Yibarach, is telling us, no, davka matzah, davka maror, then you could say, Hashem Hashem Mitzvah Mitzivanu. Hashem Mitzvah Shabbat V'yom Tov Achilat Erev Yom Kippurim, that you could have eaten even without this Tzavat HaBorei Barach, ki itbiya HaBorei Bateva, but he made it in the nature that every person wants to eat in order to satiate himself. V'en Nikar Be'achilato Shum Inyan She'ochel Mechamat Tzavat Hashem Yibarach, and there's nothing that's going to come and tell you that you're doing it just for Hashem Yibarach. He didn't tell you you have to have pastel on Friday night. He had to tell you specifically what type of a food. He didn't tell you. So there's nothing there. So he says, right? So he says, you also eat like that every day. That's what we learn about Beracha. Avashek Shem Mitzutav. Right? V'dugma lezeh titsa b'sanedin. Amal revacha medit ilravina. V'livrech alea tov metiv. Mika tov metiv. Right? So he says, I'm not sure exactly what the Gemara there is talking about, but he just asked, why don't we make the bracha v'tov ha-metiv? So he says, one second, if it was chaser, do you make dayan ha-emet? That now you're going to make a tov ha-metiv when you're going to have it? So the Gemara asks, make both of them. So he says, so no, he says it's normal, so therefore you don't make a bracha. But I'm not sure exactly what we're referring to there.
That's funny because I was thinking of the mitzvah of the kiddu when we have a second wine, and we say the beracha of atovu metiv. It's a better wine. But again, I thought that wasn't even a question because again, it's not a mitzvah. I'm just giving hoda'ah to Hashem, so it's not really
exactly
a blessing. That's why.
Yeah. Okay. This is the next halacha. Chet, okay? Sarich Adam Lizdarez Kimitavi Hutol Habed the Shabbat of Philip Dvar Muat. Ki Echad Amarbe Echad Amamit Uvil Vachi Chaveli Bola Shamai. So a person should try as much as possible to be Mechabed the Shabbat, even in a small amount, because whether you're going to do a large amount or a small amount, as long as you have Kavanah to Hakadosh Baruch Hu, it's all the same. Okay? Says the Chet. Be Shabbat Ita. In Shabbat it's brought down. Afilu davar mu'at lichvot Shabbat right asao. I mean, even if you did a small amount for lichvot Shabbat, that is oneg Shabbat. Maihi, what is that? I'm Rabba Kisa Dirsana. We're talking about the small fish. Right, that's what it says here. Dagin tanim tuganim shemen kilbehen uvekemach. So they used to take like sardines and they used to fry it, right, with the
chanketes.
What?
Chanketes.
Okay, chanketes. Right? Well, it's Venezuelan?
No, that's very Spanish. And Gibraltar, Ceuta, everybody, yeah. They're small little fish that they're fried.
But they fry them. Okay, very good. So then it says, V'chen amru b'psachim, Segmin is brought down b'psachim, Tanel v'Eliyahu, we learned in the Kanye v'Eliyahu, Afri shablu Rav Akiva, Aseh shabat echol chol v'al tzerch l'briyot, Osehu davan mu'at b'toch b'to, right, even though he says you should make your Shabbat chol and not need the biriyot and not need whether it's going to be the people, he says asesh davar mu'at betoch beto. Mainly, what is that exactly? Kisa dehirsana, the same thing, the small fish. Ketamanan bet Yosef matzati bepirkei avot the Rashi zal techer lota mishna Rabbi Kiva omer asesh shabatecha chol shniya hi deben tema. Right, v'zeleshono. This is what it means. Kloma, the beperek arve psachim. In the chapter of arve psachim, tonight we learned lo yivchatu lo midale kusot yain. Right, they can't give him less than 4 cups of wine on Pesach. Ve'afilu mina tamchui. And even if he's collecting from the tamchui, So they asked in the Gemara there, Pshita, obviously. So we answered, no. We're talking about even according to the Kiva, that he said, Aseh Shabbat Chachol, Hacha Mishum Pisume Nisa Modeh. Because of Pisume Nisa, it's going to be permitted. Right? He's going to be Modeh, that you should give it to him as well. So says the Gemara, Tanad Veliyahu, Afa Pish Amar Bekiva, Aseh Shabbat Chachol Bat Zimriot, Avalo Seh Devar Mela Batok Batok, mind you, what is that? Amar Papa, Ki Sadir Sana, Ki Tzinan Rav Yudav and Tamal, Merav Yaskar Amar Kal Kadeshin. Pina Shashi, what is Haveaz? Hitchazek b'mitzvot yoter ma'yechol b'yadcha, which means when it says that you have to become bold, right? Haveaz kaname, like a leopard, means you have to do more than what you're able to do the Torah mitzvot. Yoter mi'yechol b'yadcha, right? V'nireh shenashi lo yagones k'tan Rabbi Yehuda ben Tamei Omer. So he didn't have this girsav, Rabbi Yehuda ben Tamei Omer. Tinken lo yatzir chomo mimesecht mimesmichut, right? Ha'id Rabbi Yehuda ben Tamei Rabbi Akiva, he doesn't have to teach us the Yudam and Tema Omer from Rabbi Akiva. Ela midin lo nichtav shama yid Yudam and Tema, ela lochich shetzrich lezerez etzmo kaneshet vekaneshet lechved haShabbat. Echite makati kashe, to lo yatzrich lidmod ken nismichut, ela miyamrim mehedia, aval bishama Rabbi Akiva sabashot lechachol, aval ose davar. Muat betoch beto, yesh lomar, even though a person is mamash pressured for money, you still have to do something. The fact that it's brought down, Yudam and Tamar right beside it, Shamina, we learned that even though he had a little bit from himself, even though he needed other people. צריך לזרז את עצמו לכבד השבת. You still have to do it. Right? וזה שכתב הטור, על כן צריך כל אדם. כלומר, אב הבישוע, אני ביותר, צריך לצמצם בשל ימים. You have to be more מצמצם during the rest of the days in order to be מכבד השבת. And you shouldn't say, איך אחסר פרנסתי בשל ימים. כי אדרה, but opposite, אם יוסיך לכבוד השבת, if you're going to be מוסיף על כבוד השבת, יוסיפו לו גם כן, they're going to add him even more to continue going. Okay? כדי תני תחליפה, right? It's brought down פריבד ביצה. That's where it says there about that the money that you spend on Shabbat and all those things, it all comes back to you. Oh, wow. Okay. You want to do one more or not?
We still have time. Let's do that.
Okay. Very good, so let's go. Hamekayem Oneg Shabbat u'michaven gan lana gufo. So imagine right now, you're going to do Oneg Shabbat, but you're also mechaven, that you enjoy it. Well, nice cervecita, I enjoy it. Yeah? So he comes and he says as follows. He says, Yine lichor ha'yish romar, devechol mitzvah sha'ikari ha'totza'a, en ha'kavana me'akevet. In any mitzvah, that the
top. Wait, Rabbi, wait, this is going on the halacha. This is going on the halacha on the top.
We have to do that's what I'm going to tell you. Read the halacha on top.
I apologize. I skipped it out. I apologize. I didn't realize. So one more time. Atet. Hamekayem Oneg Shabbat mechavin lanat gufo. Somebody's going to be mekayem an Oneg Shabbat. He has also come up for himself. Some people say that he wasn't mekayem mitzvat Oneg Shabbat, and some people argue. Velachen, and therefore, the nachon is lechavim ha'lechilato l'shem mitzvat Oneg Shabbat. To have kavanah that it's only for l'shem mitzvat Oneg Shabbat. And some people say that the mitzvah that sheikar yeh totzah and the kavanah me'akevet, and that's what he's going to bring down now. Okay, so it says you like this.
No, wait. That was too fast.
Sorry.
Amekayem oneg shabbat u'mechaven le'anat gufo. So he has two kavanot. Yesh omnim shelo kiyem mitzvah oneg that he didn't do anything. Yesh cholkim ve'lachin anachon lekaven ba'achilato le'shem mitzvah oneg shabbat.
Exactly. Meaning don't have one kavanah. Exactly.
One kavanah, not so don't have two kavanot, one for Hashem, one for my body, but rather mix it to and say, let my body, let my achila fulfill the mitzvah. So one, don't do two kavanot, do one and kind of make an insalah.
No, it's not really an insalah. That therefore he's just saying, since some people argue and they say that if you had a kavanah also for yourself, you're not going to be yotzei chovah. So therefore, the nachon is lechaven only for Shabbat. Not for any other reason. But then he says, in brackets, I don't know why he brings this in brackets, and then that's the first thing that he talks about. But he says, v'yesh omrim, some people say that by here, since the ikar is the totza'ah, not the kavana, the ikar is, how do you say that? The ma'aseh, the outcome. What was the outcome? You benefited on Shabbat. So what do I care about the kavana? Yeah, you understood?
Yeah.
Okay. So he says like this, hinei lichora, yesh lomar, v'chol mitzvah she'ikar hi ha'totza'ah, en ha'kavana mitakevet. So lichora, I want to say that in any mitzvah, that the yikar is the totza, is the outcome, the result, en ha'kavana mitakevet. So then the kavana should not impede. V'kan, and here, ha'ikar hu she'e meunag b'shabbat. The yikar is ziyavonag Shabbat. What do I care about your kavanot? We don't have shara kavanot here. We need Oneg Shabbat. You had Oneg Shabbat. Just like we found similar to this, right? Interpersonal relationships. You have tzedakah. Right? What happens? Since at the end of the day, the ikar is that he gets his tzedakah. What do I care about the kavanot? What do I care about what our kavanah is? Our kavanah was for kavod, for we felt bad for them, we had mercy, whether it's for another million reasons. I don't know what.
What weird. Why don't you say from the get-go that the mitzvot, lav le'anot nitnu. So it doesn't matter. They're not given for ana'ah. So if you had ana'ah, great. You didn't, great. It doesn't matter. So even if I have ana'ah, it doesn't count because the mitzvot were not given for ana'ah. That's what we say with many things, right?
Even though mitzvah lav le'enot ninu, but here the mitzvah is le'enot.
No, I know, but I'm doing the mitzvah. So, okay. I'm getting kavanah for my goof? Okay, great, who cares? It doesn't matter because then I'm doing the mitzvah. So, okay, I want to have kavanah, my pleasure. That's an extra bonus that you're getting. But at the end of the day, we are posking all the time that the mitzvah lav le'enot ninu. And therefore, it doesn't matter if I had ana, because that's not important. The important thing is that you do the mitzvah, actually. You understand what I'm trying to say? You know, like we see a lot of times where they talk, oh, you're not allowed to have ana. And then, for example, we saw it with regards to eating certain things or doing certain things. And we say, ah, it's a mitzvah. And then I saw that they bring the chachamim all the time. Go, well, it doesn't matter because the mitzvah, love, and it doesn't matter that you're getting ana. It doesn't matter. For an Abel, you know, he can't do certain things. And then you say, well, it doesn't matter. He's doing mitzvah. Ah, but he's getting ana. Doesn't matter because the mitzvot are not for ana.
I do remember that brought down to do with, for example, if the goy turns on the light for you on Shabbat, are you allowed to learn Torah? Right, and okay. They bring also the same thing in a beautiful lacha to do with mitzvot lav le'enot ninu, and then they bring it down. However, though here though, I don't know if we would say the same thing. I'm not sure. The only reason why I would say that we don't say the same thing is because it's like the Talmud Torah that you're supposed to benefit from the Talmud Torah, which means you can't tell me a mitzvah lav le'enot ninu if the entire mitzvah was le'enot. You understand? Which means that the entire mitzvah is supposed to be le'enot.
But you could say it's a bonus.
So it's like a bonus. It could be, I don't know. Okay, let's see if he brings it down, but then I'm not sure. Okay. So here he says like this. Here he says, "V'kan ha'ikar hu she'yeh meunag b'Shabbat," and we find this by Ben Adam L'Chavero. The ikar is the tozah, the outcome, the results. So the kavanah. What do I care about the kavanah then? Okay. Kmo shebi'anu b'Yalkut zavi l'chol kibud avayim shegin da marashlanda b'sevra v'atzion gebe yasiyat tzedakah. The maaseh atzmo mo'il af b'li machshev mitzah. It means the fact that you gave tzedakah helps, even though there was no kavanah whatsoever. Right? We don't care. So he says, "Chmo shem Rabbi Roshna, how merzel azel itzaka? Somebody is going to say, 'I merzel azol itzaka.' I mean, not sheichye benid on condition that my son should live. This is tzadik gamur. Ve'omer ve'amar Adoni Avi Mori ve'Rabbi. This is the note of Yehuda. Now he comes and he says, 'A tam shebechol a mitzvot tzarich la'asot mitzvah l'shem shamayim ve'lo amela lekabe pras.' Not because you're supposed to receive a reward. Ma she'enken, on the other hand, though, bitzaka shadi bechol mitzvot Hashem imeno osel l'shem mitzvah imamash." Any other mitzvah, if you didn't do it, okay, there's nothing there. But by tztaka, even if you don't have a machshava, at the end of the day, you have the result. What does he care now if you have the kavanah of lishma, not lishma? It doesn't matter. Gam meshut itulu b'tshuva katav the same thing. Shebimitzvah shebin adam lechaveru ein tzorech kavana. You don't need kavana. Ve'omnam mechol avin mikayim mitzvah shebin adam lechaveru lo kavana chaser b'shlemut. So he says there is chaser b'shlemut a mitzvah. It's true. It's not a full mitzvah, right? Sharei asiyat a mitzvah tzuya b'shnehem benoten uvamekabel. It's in the giver and the receiver. However, though. It's not like a mamash me'akev. Ulfize gam mitzvot oneg shabbat. It should be the same thing. Ein tzarich lechavel l'shem mitzvah. At the end of the year, mitaneg b'shabbat. Vayim meshut sharei de'a chelek al shekatav shebechol mitzvot shebin adam lechaveru matzino shelo ekpid ha'Torah al kavana. Any mitzvah ben adam lechaveru. We didn't need kavana. Sheikar mitzvot shebin adam lechaveru itakanat ha'olam. It's for the world. Vayim sheratzav borei barach le'tiv l'bruav. You wanted that everyone should have good. Lo echpal lam bekavanat osikam. We don't care about the kavana. Right? Ah, your kavanah was for I don't know what. What do you care? Do the mitzvah. We don't care what the kavanot are. So he says, "V'vud v'divrem b'shut ibi omer, v'shut chazon avadia, and v'shut perador." V'omnam kvar yizkarnu le'el b'resh siman, mashkta v'shla kadosh, ki lo ne'emar kol ha'mitaneg b'shabbat, ela kol ha'me'aneg et ha'shabbat. It doesn't say kol ha'mitaneg. It says me'aneg. So we already brought above, if you remember, that the pshat was you're not supposed to do it for yourself. You're supposed to do it for other people, not for yourself. Okay? The Rabbeinu Agaon of Yosef Chaim brings out in the Sefer Ben Ish Chayil, the Kuntras, Shenel Yahu Katav, by the Sefer Ben Ish Chayil was usually for the Dala Derashot, the Arba Parashiot. Right? Like the Dala Derashot, you know, Shabbat Kala, Shabbat Teshuvah, Shabbat Agadol. They used to give the rashot. So it says, okay, it says over here, שהעושה מצווה שיש בה ענת הגוף, כאכילה מצה בלב פסח, ועונג שבת ומצוות עונה, ומכוון לשם מצווה וגם לענת גופו. So here we had a few of them. Eating מצה, עונג שבת, and עונה. Okay, all three of them. So he says, and you have covenant for both. שפיר, right? He says, חשיב שפיר כמצווה מאוחר. It's also מצווה מן המאוחר. כדמור בהוריות. Amra b'yochra ma'id yichtiv ki yesharim tarkei Hashem tzadikim l'chubam b'shim yichashubam. We saw this pasuk already a few times. What does it mean that the paths of the tzadikim, or the paths of Hashem are righteous? Tzadikim will go through it and the poshim are going to stumble in it. Mashal l'shinem ed adam shetzulu pizchem echad achlo l'shem mitzvah alav ne'mar tzadikim l'chubam ve'echad echlal she'achlo l'shem chila gasa alav ne'mar poshim yichashubam. So the Gemara says, they both did their korban Pesach. One of them, though, did it for his own self. Right? Achila gasa was the mitzvah chuba. Poshim kashubam. The other one was doing it for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Tzadikim yichubam. So Amale, right? Reshakish, says Reshakish, Rasha karitale. Why did you call him a Rasha? Rasha. What Rasha? Because it says poshlim. Right? The fact that I went and I ate a Korban Pesach with kavana for myself as well, I'm called a poshea. Called a Rasha. So he says, Nehidulav imitza min umchar, right? Pesach mi akachi, but he still ate the Korban Pesach. Umevuar so it comes out, Shafilu lo nitkavel neshe mitza, yetzadeh mechubah. You already worried with the chubah. Wash it up on Abam. Kanekva min chubah mechubah 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 or with immorality, he's also going to be chayav. Why? Mimila is nene. He doesn't have to have kavanah to be nene. Even if you're mitasek, without realizing it, you are nene. That's natural. Therefore, you're going to be chayav. Ve'ach enami, so to hear. Kevin shenene b'achilato yitzeh lechuvah. Since you're nene from eating it, you're going to be yitzeh lechuvah. Im ken eneso keshvit kaven l'shem mitzvah ve'gam l'anakuf. If you have kavanah for both, it's also mitzvah l'muchad. But it's not mufchar legamre, right? He says, "Velo avi mufchar gamun mishufre shufre," not from the best of the best. Okay, ad kan. After the Rabbi Yochanan and Reshakish shalachak Rabbi Yochanan, Shema ha'acha hadar kibble minem. Maybe he actually retracted. Velo nitkavel lachlok lav l'shalok k'da shevo shevel lo advar. And he didn't want to argue on him. He just wanted to ask on him. Because the question was, according to Shitat Rabbi Yochanan, he is Be'emet Arasha. So if it's Be'emet that he's going to become Arasha, so then we pass like Rabbi Yochanan. So the entire thing here does falls apart. So he says, no, maybe Be'emet, he retracted. Right? Maybe Be'emet, he retracted. Uveshut, Yabia Omer, Chelek Vav, Yir al Zemi Midat HaTosvot, Egar Se Pesach Mi Akavin, Upilush HaTosvot, Shein Lo Likrot Tor Rasha, כיוון שקיים מצווה שחיטת הפסח ושקוראים מצוות אכילה, ואכילה פסחים לא מעקבה, אין שם. So according to this, there's no proof from the Gemara. It says, why? Because when he says that he did the mitzvah of Pesach, he did the shechita of the Korban Pesach, not the achila. Because there's no mitzvah to eat the Korban Pesach. There's only the mitzvah, which is the shechita of Pesach. And look also the Chazon Ovadia and Meor Yisrael. Weposkim danu b'chayotze b'ze legamem mi shekanus, shekonesetim imto l'shem noi. What happens if a person wants to do Yibum? And when he's doing Yibum, he's only doing it because his sister-in-law is beautiful. She's a pretty woman. So what do you want? So that's why he's doing it. So he says, so he's doing both together. So he says, according to Abba Shaul and the Poskim like him, because remember, right? Eshet Achoto, the wife of your brother is always prohibited. It's only by Yibum that the Torah permitted, right? And if you're not doing it properly, it could be you're doing an avira of Giluy Arayot, mamash immorality. So therefore, he's saying, was the pshat in Abba Shaul that he agrees to the Chachamim that only if you have Kavanah, you're only doing it for beauty, then Be'emet it's a problem, because it's you're like Pogea Ba'erva, which is your sister-in-law. The Karov of Lad Yomamzer, agree that the child will even be a mamzer. Okay, Mashenkin, Mitkaven, Leshen Noy, Leshen Yitzat Kacha. Maybe we have covenant for both. Le Lamba, maybe there's no problem. Or Dilmar, maybe no. Kevin Shish Tarov, it's covenant psula. Since there's a mixture, there's an ensalada, Asur. It's going to be Asur. Shudya be a woman and now Lehid Bazen, Midivra Ram, Shavim Ashadavarashva, Bilushapir, Bilushalmi, Shemutal, Linol Beto, Beshabbat, Keshatzi, Betocho. You're allowed to lock the door on Shabbat when the deer is inside the house, right? Kishut tzarich lishmor beito. When you have to watch, make sure that nobody's going to come into your house. Now, even though by doing that, you're doing tzad mimeila, but he says mefurash, as long as you don't have kavanah to catch the tzvi by itself. Meaning, if you have two kavanot, it's okay. One kavanah is asur. Okay? Dachi yasim l'sham, if you said l'sham l'chanina, it's going to be permitted. So he saw a child that was coming up from the river. So when he picked up the child, he picked up a whole bunch of fish with him. So now he caught a whole bunch of fish with the child. He caught a big fish. Yeah, a small fish and a big fish. Yeah. So he says, yeah, in such a case, so the Ran comes and he says, it's a pele. What, just because he has to close his house, we're going to permit him to do melacha on Shabbat? Not only that, even if you don't have kavanah to close the door because of the deer, if you know that the deer is inside, and you can't have it, that he's not going to be trapped inside. Says Rabbi Shimon, you're going to cut off its head. What, he's not going to die? Obviously, if you cut off the chicken's head, it's going to die. You didn't have it all covered up for the tzvi. But you only wanted to lock your door. Ah, that even though afterwards you found that the tzvi is going to be shamur b'tochol mutar, because you're not going to be chayav to open up your door again. Right? So the same thing applies to the tinok. That he's drowning in the river. Right? So he says, lo sheyu domim zelaze, it's not mamash domeh. As he says, because to do pikuach nefesh, even if you have a kavanah to do a melechet reshut with pikuach nefesh, it's going to be mutar. That's what we brought down in the Gemara in Yomah. Matam in this, melechet mitzvah v'chova hi alav. It's an obligation for you to do pikuach nefesh. And therefore, afshu mitkaven imutom lechal melechah, even though you have kavanah for something else, she asura b'shabbat, the rabbis permitted it, in order that you're not going to stop the pikuach nefesh, right, that you're going to do it because it's an obligation. So therefore, however, the melechet reshut, chas v'shalom natir, mufizes, according to this, Lomi by La Rashba, not only according to the Rashba, that you should permit this halakha, right? That even if you have two kavanot, it should be okay. But even according to the Ran, since you're doing the mitzvah of a Yibum, Okay, even though you're also doing it for beauty, it should be permitted. Why? Because pikuach nefesh of Shabbat is dechuyahu, velo hutra. Pikuach nefesh was never permitted on Shabbat. It was just pushed off on Shabbat. Nafkamina, how do you do it? You understand? And all the other things as well. You understand? This is all the nafkaminas with doctors and everything, all the rules. Right? Why? Because of this. It's not hutra. Hutra just means it's everything's muta. No. It's pushed off. It's dechuy. So he comes and he says, I lost the place. Here it is. Right? כמו שדבר רן, וכמו היבום לבא שאול. ואין לומר דווקא פיקוח נפש שתהיו שתהיה מנחה אסורה עמו. He says, maybe only by פיקוח נפש will be permitted it, and not by another mitzvah. שהרי הרן סיים בלשונו ללכת לשולחן ששון העתיד. But in a mitzvah, which is an obligation, it's permitted. אלא אם כן נחלק בין איסור למצוון, that's going to make a differentiation between negative and positive. Right? That by הנשא, באין כוונה לשם מצווה. Right? Which is the עשה הויבום. So by the Aseh of Yibum, you need Kavanah to do the mitzvah only. If you had a Kavanah of another Kavanah, it's not going to be good. But you can't learn it from other Yisurim. So we have to look into this. Baruch HaShulchan, שכתב לו כאן ארוך השולחן, הרי יוסף wrote down, שאף הבא שאול דאמר הכונסי לנטול לשנו ילשים המון, הרי זה כבוגע בערבה. Means even though this same הבא שאול that we learned above said, the person gets married to his sister-in-law as Yibum, and he also had Kavanah for money, right, because remember, the one that gets married to the sister-in-law gets the inheritance. Right? He's the one that mamash takes over the entire everything of the brother. So therefore, what happens is that if he also did it for Noy or Mamon, he's like pogia berva. He's mamash getting into erva. So he says over here, that a person should always do chalitza if he has a chance. He should always do chalitza before yibum. Your chashash is that maybe that you're not going to do the mitzvah at all. But even though if you're going to have double kavanah, there's no problem whatsoever. So again, the truth is though, he didn't even explain the rest of it. Wow. But did you realize this long, long hara was only on the brackets over here? He didn't bring down the machloket. Like the entire thing was just to prove what he was saying, that the by mitzvah that the ikar is a totzah and a kavanah me'akevet. Interesting. Okay, fine. Very good. So we finished the...